Hello and welcome to BPS Technology's monthly webinars, episode 3, Computer Science Education Week, November 28th, 2018, 7 to 7:30. My name is Nicholas Gonzalez and I am accompanied by Rihanna Gutierrez, Edward Considine, and Mark Pijanowski. Thank you for attending. Today's theme is Hour of Code. Yes, it's coming. And if you'd like to follow along with this slide deck, we are at bit.ly/BPSCSED18webinar. That's Boston Public Schools Computer Science Education 18th webinar. And the link to our resource document, because we're going to be talking about some computer science education resource documents throughout the webinar tonight. If you'd like to take a look at some of them or review them or use them in your class during Computer Science Education Week, which is Hour of Code Week, go to bit.ly/BPSCSED18notes. This webinar will address five frequently asked questions about Computer Science Education Week and Hour of Code. Just to not mix you up, Hour of Code and Computer Science Education Week are essentially the same thing. So don't mean to trip you up if I use two different terms. We know it mostly as Hour of Code, but it's also called Computer Science Education Week. We're going to be addressing five different questions within within this webinar that pertain to Hour of Code, five frequently asked questions. And one of them is, what is Hour of Code? What are we talking about here? And why should schools participate in it? Well, Hour of Code was started by code.org in 2013. And it's a one-hour introduction to computer science that takes place during Hour of Code, which is this year is December 3rd through 9th. During this week, we challenge our schools to provide at least 1 hour of computer science, not just our schools, but every classroom, 1 hour of computer science or coding lessons to all students to introduce them to the field of computer science. There's a lot of coding in schools now. There's a lot of computer science in schools. There are a lot of technology courses as well. But this isn't limited to just them. We want people from all backgrounds and content areas to participate in this because coding is essential. And learning the language of computers, coding or computer languages, is really important for our students because they are entering a world that exists with computers everywhere and that are involved in jobs and throughout all of the professions now. Even if your students already learn computer science though, Computer Science Education Week is a good opportunity to do something special to bring new awareness to the computer science fields and careers that are popping up. Code.org also sponsors raffles for schools who are participating in Hour of Code. This year they are awarding over 100 classrooms with physical computing and robotics kits. You could sign up at hourofcode.com/US. So question number 2, how is BPS Technology supporting Hour of Code and Computer Science Education Week? Hour of Code is a great opportunity for us to highlight great work that our students and schools are doing around computer science. For the last 3 to 4 years, we've jumped in percentages of schools participating from 60%, I believe, to our last Hour of Code, which was well over 80%. So almost all schools in BPS participate in Hour of Code. And again, it's a great opportunity to highlight work that our students and our schools are doing around computer science, the growing field of computer science too. We host student contests every year to celebrate Hour of Code. This year we have 5 categories: Scratch Animation, Scratch Interactive, Scratch Games, Physical Computing, and Anything Goes. Physical Computing and Anything Coding, Physical Computing and Anything Coding are video entries and are designed to be very broad to accept entries from anyone, pre-K all the way to high school. So if you have no background in computer science or technology, these are the contests for you. Anyone can do them, and all they do is involve video. Again, they're broad and they're designed for the technology newbie and the non-computer science background teacher. We also hold raffles for participating schools and teachers and encourage all classrooms to participate. More details and specific instructions are at bit.ly/BPSCoders. Again, that's bit.ly/BPSCoders. So on to question number 3. What are some things schools have done for the Hour of Code? Some schools do school-wide events or parent events. Some schools bring in professionals to help the class or to speak to students about careers in computer science. If you are already teaching computer science, this might be a good time to have students do presentations or showcase their work. but don't feel like you have to do something major, or, you know, don't feel like you have to do a heavy lift. Most schools facilitate Hour of Code activities during the regular school day. So it's not something that you have to do after school or before school. If you can find a way to build it into your standard day, that's great. That's fine. You're participating in Hour of Code. You should register at bit.ly/BPSCoders. Get your school on the map. It's great. Again, over 80% of our schools participated last year, and it would be great to have you involved as well. I'm not a computer teacher, so should I still participate? Yes, and yes, absolutely. Computer science is not just for computer technology teachers. Hour of Code, the website, hourofcode.com, has a lot of pre-made tutorials that can be easily implemented by all teachers, even with no coding experience or technology experience with computers. You can even filter them by subject. So it is very important for every student to get exposure. So if your school does not have a computer teacher, or if your students don't have regular computer or technology courses, feel free to circle back with some of the teachers that have done unplugged activities for Hour of Code, because there are a lot out there. Because the most important thing for Hour of Code and learning how to code and learn how to program is not necessarily utilizing your computer and to do all the work for you. There's actually a lot of thought that goes into it. And computational thinking is one of the things that we really want to promote here at BPS Technology, because computational thinking allows you to use the languages that are associated with coding and are associated with computers. You don't necessarily need a computer to teach computer science. And again, a lot of computer science courses at the high school level and even at the middle school level and even at the college level do not start using a computer until, you know, sometimes the second or third week. So again, you don't need a computer to teach computer science, and we really suggest that you go to CS Unplugged to find some computer science activities that you can do without actually needing a computer. How do I teach CS Unplugged? So if you can take a look at some of the printables that are there, here's some really good activities. So go ahead and click on Sorting Networks. So again, this is a really good way to how computer networks work, and it's a great way shows how routing and how switching works and how it goes from one place to the other. And again, it's a really great way to teach the ideas of networking without actually even having a computer in front of you. Go to Pixel Painter. So for artists out there, this is a great way to look at the different ways pixels are used to make art and how they use images. Don't necessarily need a computer for this either, but you can create some and you can show how pixelation works with imaging and images for computers. Question number 5. What can I do if I don't have access to computers during my class? Yeah, we just went through that right now. Again, coding doesn't necessarily need computers. There are many engaging unplugged activities, and we just went through a couple of them. And again, you don't necessarily need to be a computer teacher to teach computer science. You can use these activities as well. Now, let's take a look at some of our past projects that we've done before. Again, we've been doing this for about 3 years here at BPS Technology, and we'll go back. I'll give them the bit.ly to the website after, Rhiannon, when we show them some of our contests. So here's our Scratch Animate Your Name challenge. First place last year was Lucy Kimmel from Orchard Gardens. It's loading the project, but she made her name. And Rhiannon, if you can go to See Inside, this is a Scratch coding that went into making Lucy's project. All right. So again, Scratch is a very good way to introduce coding and computer science to beginners. And again, Scratch works like Legos, and so you plug blocks into each other, and you're able to actually manipulate the graphical user interface on the left using these coding blocks. And Rihanna, let's go to one more. There you go. This was Danny. And you can, if you look inside, you can see some of the blocks that he used to make his name, and you can see Scratchy the cat in the middle. So these were the blocks that were used for his project right here. And again, these all relate to real computer languages such as Java and Python. So let's go ahead and go back to the website for BPS coders for Hour of Code this year. Let's scroll down and show them some of the different challenges that we've had last year. Again, these aren't the same challenges that we're going to have this year, but these are some of the things that we did in the past. And again, Hour of Code is a very, very, it's an important event. It's probably one of the largest education events in the world because the entire world is doing it during the same week. And again, it's a pledge by all schools throughout the world internationally to do at least 1 hour of code with their students. If you're interested in Hour of Code and finding out more about it, please go to hourofcode.com to find out some of the raffles that are being sponsored by hourofcode.com. And please, if you're interested in doing this, don't forget to register at bit.ly/bpscoders. There's a place to register your school, and you'll show up on the map, and you'll be recognized by BPS Computer Science here at BPS Tech. If you have any questions whatsoever about this and you want to get involved, please email us, Nick Gonzalez or Haruna Hosokawa, at bpscomputerscience@bostonpublicschools.org. This is Nick Gonzalez signing off. Thank you so much for watching, and have a good time coding, and you have a great time doing your hour of code at your school. Thank you so much. And again, if you have any questions, please contact us at bpscomputerscience@bostonpublicschools.org.